Hey, welcome to Cleveland Heights Committee of the Whole meeting. It's May 19th, 2021. Our first agenda item is legislation. City Manager, Ms. Nerman O'Neill, please.
We have five pieces of legislation tonight, and they are the Coventry Road Rehab Legislation with the GPD Group. And this allows them to start the engineering and the design work on Coventry from Fair Hill to Euclid Heights Boulevard. But that work will not begin until 2022. This is just the prep work, which on a road like that takes a lot of time. So that's that. And then Amy always puts in her budget adjustment amendment. We also have the ordinance regarding the firefighters agreement, and this would be final approval from City Council for the compensation rates going forward over the next 3 years. The basic salary increase for each year is a 2%. Then on first reading, we have Power of a Clean Future Ohio. And I know that Khalil Seren is having a committee meeting next week on the 25th to address with people who would be speakers more information about this legislation. And then you all know tonight's the vote on the consent decree information, the city sanitary sewer overview. So there's five pieces tonight.
Okay, Cleo just came on board. No one had any questions up till now. Cleo, we just went over legislation. Did you have any questions for the city manager before we move on?
No, thank you.
Oh, Craig. You're on mute, Craig.
Sorry about that. On the consent decree and voting tonight, I think at our last meeting, we had discussed the possibility of holding a special meeting to do that. I don't know if we're committed to voting on that tonight. I think I'd like a little more time to consider exactly how much of this money we're going to spend towards that. And since we just found out within the last week or so permissible users, I think we should give that some consideration.
Tonight you would only be voting on the plan, not the financial piece of it.
When do we have to commit to the financial piece?
Bill Hanna?
Council can commit to the financial piece this evening or upon adoption, if that's not this evening, prior to submitting the plan, or the plan that outlines the work and the timetable and the costs can be submitted, but that leaves open the question of how those costs will be paid for, which is through rate increases, absent some other source of funds.
So the drop dead date on making that financial decision is to meet the June 1st deadline?
No.
No.
No. Okay.
The June 1st deadline is getting the report in of what we intend to do.
But we don't have to deal with the financials until later? Is that this what you're saying?
That's my understanding, Bill. Amy?
I think as a technical matter, that's correct. Without getting into any of the, you know, strategic recommendations that might implicate litigation-related questions, I think that is correct.
Melody, then Cleo.
So when they discussed it before and through the presentations we've had, they had the chart showing when money would be spent, depending on how much we elect to put in cash. So if we're giving the plan, aren't we telling them we're going to do this at this point and this at this point and this at this point? And wouldn't that change depending on what the financing was?
Yes, I think there are some impacts of the timing of the expenditures, which are shown in some of the charts and graphs that were presented in April during the two webinars, as well as the summary that council has seen. It may be that the city's council can ask, answer these questions in much greater detail, along with other considerations in executive session, which is on your agenda for this evening, if you want to have that conversation then. But I think that from a, again, from a base technical standpoint, I think Susanna's answer is correct.
Okay, Cleo.
Okay, I just have one quick question. Maybe it's two. The source of the funds for completing these projects, does that change the amount of money that we will have to spend to complete them or the number of projects that we will have to complete?
I don't believe it does. I believe okay. We're still doing the same amount, the same dollar amount. It's just how it's paid for.
Second question, and this maybe is sort of expanding on the previous question. We also recently figured out that the money does not, certain sources of money have a deadline for spending through 2026. And that change in the requirement may or may not change what we choose to fund from certain sources rather than other sources. And so I'm curious about the, if we don't have to commit to a financing scheme, will it change our timeline if we haven't taken a look at when the projects have to be completed according to the funding sources? And if so, then what does that do to what projects we do when? And if we're submitting a plan for what we're doing, what changes in the plan would be required if we you know, adjusted the timeline?
You know, my recommendation would be that we try to pull Lou McMahon into the discussion to answer these questions, since he's been helming this effort for the last 4 to 5 years. And I think that we have other folks on standby, not currently patched in, who can assist with that if we need to get them involved. I don't want to misspeak about the impacts of those decisions tonight.
Anyone else? Greg.
Question. This legislation on the city's master plan references the document that's on draft form in the city's director's public works office. Is that online currently?
It is not.
Okay. So we're voting on legislation that references a document that I don't think is in our packet, is it?
It is not.
Okay, that's a problem for me. So we need to email that out.
Yeah, I don't know if you have looked to you know, obtain that from the director since the last meeting or not, but you know, that can be made available.
Is that in prior materials that we were given?
No, it is not. It is still in development. The most developed copy is on file. It is still being worked on because it's a gargantuan project and the deadline is June 1st. So council has received a summary of the plan and additional materials, and that copy can be provided to council.
And not to be difficult, but we've known about this June 1st deadline for how long? A while, right?
Four years.
And I feel that now we're suddenly sort of being rushed.
Okay, Khalil.
I don't know if Craig is suggesting this or not, but if he is suggesting that we schedule another meeting to have a vote on this and not vote on it tonight, have a discussion and then hold it, or you know, you can read it into the record, but not vote on it this evening. If that's what Craig is suggesting, I support that.
So here's my concern, and I understand we have to vote on something. I just don't want to lock us into a financial plan without having all of the various options explained to us in light of the COVID money that we have available. And I'm also troubled by our passing legislation that references a document, and I understand it's large, that at least should have been posted online for us to take a look at. Because I'd like to know, since it references this, what it is we're approving. Not to be difficult, but I guess I am sort of being difficult about that.
That's not being difficult, that's reasonable.
Well, we still have two Mondays left in the month. So typically those Monday meetings, we're meeting and committee the whole. And that's easy enough to add on a meeting where we can actually take a vote. I guess depending on how much time, Bill, you think you need, if you need all the way up to the 31st, then I guess we have until that point to vote on this, unless there's some objection that we're unaware of.
No, it has to be submitted on the 1st, so approval prior to the 1st would suffice. I really, though, would defer all questions to the city's outside counsel, who's been working on this for 5 years and is working with the city's outside engineers to develop the final version of that report. I'm simply not in a position to give counsel the utmost details. He is available. He is available for this call at this moment if counsel wants to bring him in executive session or to ask questions in the public session. And we can answer them as best we can.
Okay, so you're saying that we can ask our questions tonight when we're in executive session, that they're going to be on with us.
Correct.
Okay. Any other questions before we move on? Susanna, do you want to say something?
Yeah, I just feel compelled to say something about the tremendous amount of work that has gone in this. And I understand the astonishment that it's due on June 1st, which is in 2 weeks. But that has nothing to do with the fact that staff and consultants have been working all this time on a massive project. And as I said earlier, the plan can be voted on without the financial numbers so that we can tell them what our intentions are going forward. But I do agree with Craig that referencing in a piece of legislation an appendix that is not available just isn't correct. And I apologize for that.
Let me just say, and Susanna, I know that you guys have worked hard. I appreciate all of the hard work that has been done. You know, I don't think we anticipated this COVID money. It sort of is complicating things, particularly since we're going to spend a substantial part of it or proposing. And I understand that's, you know, out of your control. So that's my only concern is I want us to have some time to make sure we make the right decision.
Right.
Okay, seeing no other questions, our second agenda item is three different executive session items. Can someone please make a motion and read it as shown on the Committee of the Whole agenda?
I move that we go into executive session to discuss with an attorney for the public body claims or disputes involving the public body that are the subject of pending court action. Two, to review negotiation and bargaining sessions with public employees or their representatives concerning such employees' compensation or other terms and conditions of their employment, and three, to consider the sale or lease of city-owned real property.
Second.
Mrs. Himmeline, please call the roll.
Cobb.
Aye.
Dunbar.
Aye.
Hart.
Aye.
Russell.
Aye.
Sarin.
Aye.
Stein.
Aye.
Unger.
Aye.
Seven ayes, Your Honor.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so we're going to go into executive session now. For those of you watching at home, it's 6:52 right now. Most likely, this is going to take us all the way up until 7:30, possibly longer. And then when we come out of executive session, I'm going to adjourn committee of the whole and go straight into our council meeting.
All right, we are now out of executive session, Your Honor. You're on mute.
Okay, committee of the whole is now adjourned.